Hi, I'm Laura Valdespino, and today I'm going to talk to you about how to navigate regulatory compliance. Just a little bit of background about myself. I've been doing compliance for about 20 years, particularly in the payment space. So basically, if you want to move money in or out of a country anywhere in the world, as long as it's not sanctioned, I'm pretty much your girl. So today, I'm going to talk to you about pay card compliance here in the United States. So some important questions to ask. Who are your payees? Who are you trying to pay? Are you trying to pay employees? Are you trying to pay your contractors? Are you trying to pay student workers? That matters because different regulations may or may not apply depending upon who you're trying to pay. What states are they located in? It matters because, as you know, here in the United States, every state likes to act like its own little country. None of them like to write the rules the same way. So are you in one state? Are you in a region? Or are you in all 50 states? What is your goal? Are you trying to go to 100% electronic pay? Or do you just want to offer a pay card as a benefit to your employees? What type of pay are you actually paying? Is it wages? Is it 1099 type contract payments? Is it a stipend? Is it a per diem? Is it an employee reimbursement? You need to ask those questions, and you can have multiple types of payments all together on one card, but it depends on the type of pay. And when are your payments due? Depending upon your industry or your state, you could have requirements around how often and how you can pay. So timing and frequency, you need to ask those questions. With a pay card, it's always a given that banking laws apply. A pay card is an account, and so all of those rules apply. Federal wage and hour laws also apply. Not because you're specifically paying on a pay card, it's because if you're paying employees, they always apply to your employees. Federal wage and hour laws will also apply if you're paying employees. Depending upon your state, you'll also need to know what are the permissible wage payment methods. Can you only pay by cash or check? Can you pay by direct deposit? And can you pay by pay card? Federal regulations will also apply, such as Regulation E and UDAP. A pay card is considered an electronic funds transfer, and therefore Reg E applies. Depending upon what industry you're in, different regulations can apply, such as if you're trying to pay tips if you're in the restaurant industry. Tips can be regulated differently than regular wages. They could be part of wages or they could not be counted as part of wages, so that may or may not apply to you. Depending upon what state you're in, there may be additional fee restrictions on the fee schedule. For instance, are you allowed to charge for in-network ATMs, or are all in-network ATMs supposed to be free? This matters. Depending upon what state you're in, you could also have different notification requirements. It's great that you want to introduce a pay card program to your employee population, but did you know in the state of Texas, you actually have to provide a 60 days notice to all employees prior to the first live electronic funds transfer to a pay card? Other states actually say 30 days. Texas is the most restrictive. And then no matter what, you want to make sure that you get consent to pay your employees on a pay card. And consent is always required. So not all programs are equal. You need to know what questions to ask. What responsibilities are yours, and what responsibilities are that of your provider? Your provider cannot take on all of your responsibilities, nor should they. What is their approach to compliance? Do they lean into compliance, or do they run away? If they can't answer your questions when asked, that's a red flag. When you ask those questions, do they oversimplify it with just a, oh, of course we're compliant, and then move on? Or are they unable to explain it in detail? You want to make sure to ask the tough questions and get the answers. If they can't, again, that's a red flag. What features do they have in their program? Is it a pay card program with a convenience check, or an actual pay card program and a check program? There's a huge difference. If you have to activate your pay card to be able to access the check feature, that's actually not compliant in all 50 states. Can they assist you with a compliant TermPay solution? Did you know that 48 states actually regulate how you have to pay termination pay if the employer discharges the employee? And then those 48 states will actually regulate it differently if the employee voluntarily resigns or quits. In some of those states, you actually have to pay that employee when you discharge them at the time of discharge. Others will then say within 24 hours, some say 72 hours, and so forth. And does your potential provider actually provide the compliance expertise that you need? Is their compliance program robust? Again, can sales talk about compliance the same way that field support can, or their implementations or rollout team can, or do they always have to take those questions away back to their compliance team? You want to ask those questions. So if you're looking at a pay card provider, you want a provider that's compliant in all 50 states. The features actually matter. You want them to be able to give you state-by-state guidelines. You want them to be able to explain the rules in California versus the rules in the state of Texas versus the rules in the state of New York. They're all very different, and you want that guidance. You want to make sure that they can also not only guide you on the pay card rules, you want them to guide you on what your responsibilities are. You want to make sure that the fee schedule that you're getting with your product is actually compliant in all 50 states. Having to manage one fee schedule is much easier and actually creates less risk for you than if you have to manage multiple fee schedules for the same program. Part of that federal regulation E that I mentioned earlier was actually that your employees have to have access to their transactions and history. Having a provider that has a mobile app that provides your employees instant access to that is a great feature. It goes above and beyond the minimum regulatory requirement. You also want your provider to have state-of-the-art cyber fraud detection and prevention tools. This is your employees' wages that we're talking about, and you want to make sure that they do everything they can to protect it from the bad guys and the fraudsters who are always trying to hack everything. You also want to make sure your provider has financial wellness tools. Now, this isn't a requirement by any regulation in any state, but it sure is a great feature. And if they've built it into that mobile app and everything else they do, then isn't it a nice benefit for your employees? You also want to make sure that your provider can provide you one solution for a 50-state compliant term pay solution. Again, you don't want to have to manage multiple versions of the same thing because of different rules. You want one solution. You also want to make sure that your provider provides you education and training on your program, not just about how to best roll it out, what seems to be the most employee friendly, but they can also provide you the compliance answers that you need in that education and training program. You also want them to be there for the life of your program. It's great that some providers will actually help you through the rollout and implementation, but are they there a year from now or 2 years from now? You want them to be there for the life of your program. You can always pick up the phone and call your provider and ask any question you need, and someone's there to answer your call. You also want to make sure that they're a continued business partner, not just here's your responsibilities, not our problem, but are they your partner? Is it a hand-in-hand partnership? And can they provide you an end-to-end compliant solution, whether it's the direct deposit, whether or not you're still issuing some traditional checks, whether or not you're paying term pay, or whether or not it's down to the pay stub. It's all the way through that you want to make sure that they can help you and ensure that you're compliant. So here's what I want you to take away today. I want you to ask the questions and expect the answers. Again, don't go easy on your provider. I also want you to make sure that your provider has an end-to-end compliant product. Again, ask those tough questions. Don't shy away from it. Do they have tools that go beyond just the minimum? Meeting the regulatory requirement, that's great. But can they go further? Is it a benefit to your employees? You also want to make sure that the compliance is not just a requirement, but it's a service. Again, are they there holding your hands? Ask that question. And do they have embedded compliance experience and knowledge in all of their teams? Again, is the salesperson sitting across from you knowledgeable in compliance versus only being able to go back to their compliance expert? Can your field support team answer those tough compliance questions? So again, I want you to ask these questions so that you can choose your provider wisely and navigate yourself into a successful pay card program. Thank you for your time today, and I hope you have a great day.